point that becomes that becomes very important for your next few semesters. And I say that I'm talking about 7th and 8th semester. Okay, but of course it's important here also, but here it is more about knowing the definition, okay, why it is coming across, all those things. But in a very depth way or in-depth way, it becomes important in your machine learning and the data science, data analytics subject which you are supposed to study in the final year. Okay, in this, what are the things that we are going to look for today? We are going to look for learning about the values of entropy and gain. Okay, also known as information gain, also known as Gini index, G-I-N-I index. Okay, information gain or Gini index, that we are going to learn. Okay, most important part, it is we are going to take in-depth analysis of it. See, this is not required when it comes to data mining in general. Of course, you need to know what is, you know, why did we come across here? Why did we come across to entropy, Gini index and all? We were trying to figure out how a decision tree will be split. And for that, you need to know, or the you need to have a knowledge of what is known as entropy, Gini index and all. So that if you know that, based on that, you can neatly split a decision tree. That is what we are talking about. So here we came across this entropy, Gini index. Then we thought, okay, let me, when anyway we are studying, you know, entropy, Gini index, you know, let us go a little bit depth into it and learn a little bit more compared to what we are supposed to read. Okay. So in yesterday's class also, we were talking about entropy. I think in the last 5-10 minutes, I even thought about what is an entropy and all, and of course the formula for it and all. So we're going to take one more example, and then we'll be looking into very, very simple, a very famous example of our information gain, a very simple example. Okay, then by that time, you know what is entropy, Gini, you know, information gain and all, which will be very good. Okay, then after that, anyway, it's all theory part from our data mining perspective. We are going to look into it. Okay, why, you know, why did we come across here? We were talking about a topic called as how to determine the best split in a decision tree, or in other words, how do you determine which is my root node so that I can draw a decision tree, or in other words, how do you determine which is my best criteria to keep as a root node so that I can neatly draw a decision tree. Okay, there we came across various points. We talked about, you know, the choice of a decision tree will depend on the attributes. And we even came across that the choice of a decision tree will depend on what type of values you are going to choose. In that type of values, you came across these two things. One was with regard to entropy, and other one was with regard to information gain, also known as Gini index. Okay, one important thing you need to keep in mind here. Okay, we are going to take one example. Okay, we are going to take one example and we are going to figure out how the entropy is calculated. For this, what I have done is I have gone and taken an example which is a lab program example. Now, when I say lab program example, what is the meaning of that? It means very simple that I have taken an example right from a place where people will always do lab program. Okay, so what is the meaning of that? Meaning is very simple. Okay, once again, yeah, this is a lab program example, lab program of machine learning. You go and do the machine learning lab. This is the best example people will give you. It's a very famous example. It's an example of playing badminton in a particular area, and that area has various attributes, day one, day two, like that, and the outlook of weather. Whether it will be sunny, whether it will be overcast. Overcast, the matlab, you know, what you see in Bangalore today. People who are in Bangalore today, they'll be knowing it. It's pretty much overcast. It's a condition which is full cloud cover. It will not rain, but it will be fully covered with the cloud. The light will be very less. Okay, that's called as overcast condition. Okay, then rain, obviously, you know. Then temperature, obviously, you know, is the one more attribute of it. Then you have humidity. Humidity ka matlab, you know, the amount of moisture in the atmosphere. Okay, that says humidity. More amount of humidity, more amount of moisture in the atmosphere. Okay, then you have the wind, you know. Then whether play tennis or badminton, okay, both, whether a person can be able to play the tennis or not, that is what is known as a target variable. What is target variable? To decide whether he can play tennis or not, and that will all depend on these sort of things. Okay, so I've taken that very famous example to figure out this. See, you take this example in two places in machine learning lab. I don't know about much about the 18 scheme syllabus, but your seniors used to take this as a two, you know, in it is this example in two lab programs. Okay, machine learning lab, very very important example. Okay, you can see this on a day one when the outlook is very sunny, temperature is too hot, okay, or just hot, humidity is good, okay, humidity is high, wind is very weak, okay, then you can easily play the tennis. No, I'm not going to play the tennis. Why? Because it's hot, I'm not going to play in a hot day. Okay, then where do you think the tennis is played? The first place where he's going to play tennis is in the third day. Okay, you check, it's an overcast condition, temperature is hot, but humidity is also high, wind is weak, so he's going to play the tennis. Okay, what is the one thing that can really figure out compared to the first one and the third one? That the temperature outlook is, here it is sunny, here it is overcast. See, when you give like this now, you can't figure out whether what is the best criteria I can figure out to say that a particular person is playing a tennis or not. Okay, there only you have all these algorithms coming through. Okay, the decision tree, ID3 algorithm, everything is coming through. So example for your ID3 example only. Okay, ID3 is not there in your syllabus in data mining, but it will come in my machine learning. Okay, if time permits, if you are able to complete syllabus and all, if your time is still there, you'll be able to do that also. Okay, for all these things, see, our job now is to make sure that we learn about entropy. Okay, that's very important. So let me go there and start off learning through it. Okay, first of all, I told you very clearly, what is the meaning of entropy? Entropy means the order of disorder, or the measure of disorder, or what's the other way of saying it? It is how much disorder or impurity or how much pure the data is. Now people not understand what is the meaning of that, right? So in very simple words, it means, or in way, you know, you're supposed to write, one second, yeah. So in very simple words, what is the meaning of this? Entropy will be giving you the amount of purity, okay? Amount of purity, or in data mining terms, or in data set terms, we can say it will be giving you the amount of what is known as the order, or the disorder, the opposite of it. So what you can take, or what is the thing that you can figure out from this? How do you think the entropy is measured? Entropy is measured in a very simple formula. What is the formula? I think yesterday also I taught you. The simple formula is entropy of a particular, you know, data is measured like this. Summation of, be careful, I starting from 1 up to the last point. Okay, up to the last point, you will be last value. Okay, minus of probability of the data log 2 of probability of the same data, or probability frequency of the same data. You will not understand this unless and until we take an example for it. Okay, so what is the example we take? We take an example of what we see right here. What is a, you know, example you can take? You can take any example. But what is the most important part? Your important part is to make sure that we figure out the target frequency here. What is the target variable frequency? These are the target variable frequency that you see right here. Okay, in this, what is the most important part? What is the two values that you're supposed to have? Whether he's playing tennis or whether he's not playing tennis. That's all simple. There's no third value right here, right? Whether he's playing tennis, positive or negative. If he's playing tennis, it is positive. If he's not playing tennis, it is very much negative, right? As simple as that. Now let's figure out, you know, him playing tennis. So where and all is playing tennis? The number of cones you check for the number of places where he's playing tennis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 9 places he's playing tennis. So can I write very clearly that the amount of positive values of it, or in terms that he's able to play tennis, the count is nothing but 9. Then the amount of negative aspect of it, okay, where he's not playing tennis, is obviously equal to 5. Why? Because there are only two values. If 9 is taking the first value, the second value should be 5, because the total number of, you know, values that you have is 14. Okay, so the negative value you came across is equal to what? 9 only. Now based on these two, Can I figure out my entropy? Yes, I can easily figure out my entropy. What is the entropy that you can have? The entropy is very simple. You are going to substitute this in this. How do you think this will happen? It will happen in a very, you know, similar way like this. First thing you can see, with regard to positive values, what is the probability? I told you very clearly, this PI is nothing but a probability frequency of a particular data or a particular target variable. In this, what is the probability that he is going to play tennis? It is nothing but 9 out of 14. Probability that he is going to play tennis is 9 out of 14. Okay, log 2 of, again, 9 out of 14. Okay, write the 14 neatly. 9 out of 14 only, see. This is with regard to 9 out of 14 neatly. Plus, you have to be careful. Okay, this is, one second. Okay, this is with regard to minus values, right? Minus of minus values, summation of minus values. So this, okay, then again, we are going to do it for a positive values now. If you are able to do it for a positive values, how we are going to do, sorry, negative values, what you are going to get? This is this one. Okay, so this will be 5 out of 14. Okay, then log 2 of 5 out of 14. Okay, so 5 out of 14. So if you sort of simplify this, okay, if you are able to simplify this, you are able to get almost a value that is equal to 0.940. This is the entropy value that you are supposed to get for the data what you saw. Now you can very clearly see this entropy value is almost equal to 1, right? It's almost equal to 1. Now entropy, always remember that entropy value will be coming in only two places, or you know, it will be between only two values. It will be either 0 or it will be 1, or it will be anything between 0 to 1. So what is the meaning of zero entropy? Zero entropy means that impurity, amount of impurity in the data is very much zero. Okay, that the data is fully homogeneous. What's the meaning of data being homogeneous? That the data is almost all same only. What is the value of entropy being equal to 1? That impurity, whatever the amount of impurity that you have, is very much high. Okay, is very much high, which basically means the data, okay, the data impurity high means the data what you see here is non-homogeneous. Okay, that the data is fully having different values here. But generally the entropy value will be anywhere between your 0 and 1, any values between 0 and 1. Now this 0.940 is almost equal to your 1. Okay, is almost equal to your 1, which basically means that it is the amount of impurity is too high. Okay, now if you sort of take the same old example and split it in a different way altogether. Okay, if you take an example like this, think that, you know, we got the values like this, amount of positive that is going to play tennis, if the value that is equal to 7. Amount of negative values that is not able to play the tennis, if that value is coming up to around again 7. 7, 7, 14. 9 plus 5, 14. So now you can check that I have put the data in two equal parts. Okay, two equal parts. Is playing tennis conditions? Yes, 7. Is not playing tennis conditions? 7. If I do for this, okay, if I do this for this, what do you think will be the entropy of it? You can see very clearly the two conditions are split in two equal parts, which basically means the data is fully mixed up. It is not at all homogeneous. Okay, it is not at all homogeneous. So the data will be like this, yes, no, yes, no, like this. So the data is not homogeneous. If I calculate for this, okay, using this same old formula, this formula, right? It's not a new thing. I'm trying to figure out using this one. Okay, once again, I'll just clear this off. Okay, so this, see, if I try to figure out using this formula only, what is the value I'm supposed to get? The value of entropy of S for this 7 and 7, I will be getting like this. Okay, what is going to happen? 7 out of 14 log 2 of 7 out of 14 minus again, okay, 7 out of 14 log 2 of 7 out of 14. If you calculate this, what is the value that you are supposed to get? You are going to get the value which is equal to 1, which clearly indicates that the data is non-homogeneous. You know the meaning of homogeneous. Homogeneous means same. Non-homogeneous means the data is fully different. Or in other way, I can say the data is very much impure. Okay, and the entropy value is equal to 1. And you can even say that this is a very good way of splitting the data. Okay, how you can split? You can see this as a condition like this. Two conditions you can have, either yes or no. So based on that, you can easily split the data without any problem. Okay, what if the data is fully homogeneous? What if I change these values to be like this? Okay, what's the meaning of homogeneous data? When you have all the positive values and is not at all playing tennis, you know, no values like this. Now this you can see, okay, this you can easily figure out one important thing here, that the data is very much pure here. What is the meaning of purity here? Purity is that he is always playing tennis. There is no condition where he is not playing tennis, right? If you do for this, the entropy value of it using this formula, okay, the entropy value of this will be equal to what? Will be equal to 0. So the data is homogeneous. The impurity, okay, the impurity aspect of it you can very clearly see. Okay, impurity is also 0 and the entropy value is also 0. This is one way of figuring out how do you decide the root node of a decision tree, or how do you decide which is the best condition to split a decision tree. Look into the wording I'm using. Okay, how do you determine the root in a decision tree, or which is the best condition for me to split the decision tree? Both the things you can easily sort of understand from this. Okay, now what's the next thing? You can see I'm talking about this example. Right, I've talked about for this example. Now let's take one more thing. Okay, we came across one more thing also, right? What was what one more thing we came across? We need to learn what is the next thing, which is with regard to information gain. This is the simplest of example for entropy. See, there's going to be a lab program. I don't know about the syllabus, but I'm sure it will be there. Okay, or at least people who are doing machine learning, they will be making you to write a Python program for a data like this. What data? This one. Okay, this data I'm talking about. You are going to figure out the entropy. You are going to figure out the information gain. Immediately you'll write a program in Python to figure out, okay, a machine learning algorithm of figuring out my entropy and information gain. Very, very important. Okay, now my next thing is to figure out the information gain, because at the same time we should not forget, what we are supposed to learn in data mining also. You're only going to learn about what is entropy, what is information gain. There's no need for you to calculate and all, but I'll be giving everything in the PPT. It will be there. Okay, so some extra information, it will be nice. So let me go into the next part. Okay, what is the next part? I was talking about information gain also. Okay, so before we take this one big example, where is that example? This one. It's a very big example. I'll take a very simple of example. You go into Google, you go into any of the test books, they'll always start with a very simple example. That simple example is like this. I myself am going to take one a data set, or whatever you call it. Generally we call it as a data for a decision tree. Okay, if I take for that, what is the example that they can have? I can have, okay, three datas I can have like this. See, it's a very famous example. You find it everywhere, so don't have to worry. Okay, so what is the example I can take? The IDs, the customer IDs of it. Okay, I'll take what is known as a loan amount. Okay, I'll say what is the loan's status. What's the thing I say? I'll say I'll take the values for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the loan amount is, say, 100, not 100 rupees, maybe 100,000, like that. Okay. Who will take 200, 200 rupees and all? Okay, now 250, 150, 300. Okay, now the loan status is also there. This is a target variable. We'll be deciding whether it is good or bad. Okay, so B will be representing bad and G will be representing your good. Okay, if I write for all other things also, it is B, G, B. B ka matlab, bad. Okay, keep that in mind. Okay, so for this, I need to figure out what is known as, see, there's only two things here, or three things here. These two are independent variables. Knowing.
Sir, Chetan sir.
Hello.
Hello, Chetan sir. Sir, am I audible?
Yes, madam. Wait a minute.
Sir, somebody removed me now because I was monitoring the class. You please disable the option of that particular control. This is happening second time in your class. Somebody is removing me whenever I try joining it.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Students, not a good attitude. Okay. Whoever removed me, please remember, if we get to know, what will be the consequences you need to face.
Okay, so let me continue. Okay, don't do all those things. Okay, just listen to the class. So that's very important. So see, what is the next thing I'm talking about? I'm talking about ID value here. Okay, ID value and your loan amount, both are independent. Okay, both are independent. Very important for you to know this. And the next part you can think of is this loan status. Loan status would have been my target variable. Okay. Is my target variable. I don't have to worry about that. These two are independent variables. Now I am going to figure out what is known as information gain here. What is the meaning with regard to information gain? Or in very simple words, they call it even Gini, G-I-N-I. Gini index, Gini, everything is same. In generally, in data science terms, in machine learning terms, we even call it as information gain. Okay. What is the things that you are going to learn in this? Very important part is machine learns in the information gain will be telling you what type of a variable you are going to choose for the root variable or the root node. Okay, you're going to choose what type of variable you're going to choose for the root node or a root variable. That's very important part here. Okay, how do you think the formula is? Because we studied about the entropy formula also. We are going to figure out the Gini index formula here. What's the Gini index formula? The Gini index formula is again a very simple one here. Okay, what is it? You are going to figure out the Gini index formula to be like this. Information gain, Gini, both are same. Okay, keep that in mind. Okay, 1 minus summation of, be careful here, again, the probability choice or the probability frequency. Okay, the whole square. Be careful, it's a whole square. Where the values are starting from 1, I is equal to 1, up to the last value. How many ever the values you have, up to the last value. You can call it as J. Some people would have written J also in their final textbooks. You can call it as J values or last values. Okay, I to J. I to J means you're starting with I or up to J values, whatever the values. Or up to from 1 up to the last value. Okay, that's very important here. The formula needs to be kept in mind without any problem. Now, if I take for this, obviously our target variable is here. If I go with regard to this or figuring out what is needs to be done, what is most thing? See, now we already know with regard to loan status. But before we're doing this, we will not be knowing whether what needs to be done or not. So we'll take between these two, between our independent variable. What are the independent variables we have? The independent variables are, one is the ID and second one is with regard to loan amount. In ID and loan amount, which one can I take as a root variable so that I can decide which is the best decision tree? Anyway, I can't take ID. ID will be varying each and every time. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 5 of them. I have to go for loan amount only. Or if there have been other fields, if you take this example, now, see, I can take day, I can't take day will, you know, keeps on changing. You can't decide things based on the day. You can't just go there and say sixth day, the play tennis is no. Seventh day, play tennis is yes, no. You're going to decide those based on the attributes that you have. What are the attributes? The outlook, the temperature, the humidity, the wind. Based on these things only you decide. You don't decide on the number of days. Okay, so these things only you're going to work through. Like that, in this example, is that example? Yeah, in this example, we are going to do based on what is known as the loan amount. And you can see it's a continuous variable. Okay, it's a continuous variable. It keeps on, you know, changing each and every time. In the previous example, what we took with regard to entropy, it was either yes or no. Okay, or if you take this example, what are the various, you know, values it can have? Sunny, overcast, rain. After that, any other things? No. Temperature, hot, cool, mild. Three things only. Humidity, high, normal. Two things only. Wind, weak, strong. Two things only. Play tennis, yes or no? Two things only. So here the amount of variations that you can have are very, very minimal. Okay, they're very minimal. But if you go into a value like this, where the values are changing, see, 100, 200, 250, 150, 300, if there have been more numbers, it'll be even more. 4350, 450, 550, like that, it'll be even more. Okay, so if the numbers are more, what we take yesterday also, yesterday in the yesterday's class, you saw with regard to continuous attributes, how you are going to use it using the range values. So for that, what is going to happen? You are going to write all these things in form of a range values. So if for that, if I write what is known as a decision tree, okay, if I write what is known as a decision tree for it, what is going to happen? The value will be basically coming through like this. I'm going to take it with regard to loan amount. Okay, if my loan amount is anything greater than 200, see, understand the symbol, I hope you must be knowing. Okay, anything greater than 200, then what I can say, I can have only two things. Is it yes or no? Loan amount greater than 200. Okay, yes or no, simple. So there is one place called yes, there will be one place called no. If there is equal, you know, value of 200, you can take equal also, not a problem. Okay, or is 200 greater means I'll be taking towards yes. You can do anything like this. Okay, greater than equal to 200, anything like that. Okay, I'll take, you know, a value which is, you know, one second, I hope it's visible. Yeah, see, I'm going to, yeah, it's going up. One second, I'll just rewrite greater than 200. Okay, now see, I, for S values, what and all are the loan statuses that you have or the target variables that you can have? For false or no, okay, what and all things that you can have? Okay, before that, if you want to write this, you know, in form figuring out the entropy and all, what and all are the loan status that you can have? With regard to loan status, what I can, you can have? Bad, how many places that you have? You have it in 1, 2, 3, three places out of 5. Okay, good, the loan status being good is coming in obviously 2 out of 5. Okay, this is very important for figuring out the entropy. Now our job is to figure out our information gain. Okay, and the formula is also different compared to the previous one. Okay, so for this, if I'm trying to figure out what is going to happen, for with regard to S, if the loan amount is greater than 200, yes, we are not going to look for, you know, just like in previous entropy, we're not going to look for figuring out bad or good. We are going to figure out for this. See, we are combining this. Okay, write it in different. We are combining the independent variable of loan amount with my loan status. So this is a more of a advantages compared to your entropy, or a better version of your entropy for me to figure out whether I can easily be able to decide whether what is the best place I can put my decision tree, or what will be my route in a decision tree. Okay, to do that, what are the things I need to do? Very simple. For if I, the loan amount is greater than 200, yes, I'm going to come as this set. In this, wherever I have greater than 200, where and all I have greater than 200, to there are only this one. Look into this, where greater than 200 I'm talking about, okay? And there's one more thing. What is that one more thing? This one. 250 and 300, two places where it is more than 200, okay? And what are the qualities that you have inside that? There are two places and both the things are saying that it is bad. Okay, both the things, see, this is count and this is the loan status. Here, when you go for no, obviously, you know, if it is 2 year, you have to get 3 year. Okay, but that 3 is coming in two different ways. What is the two different ways? 2 is coming as good. Check here. Other 2 you check. Other 3 you check. I'm talking about these ones. This, this and this. See, there are 2 things which are coming as good. Okay, and there is one more thing that is coming as bad. Okay, now for this, if you found out the information gain. Okay, if you find out the information gain, then we can sort of decide what needs to be done. Okay, what is my best option? So what is the information gain if I find out for this one? I'm talking about this side value. If I find out the values of this, what will be the information values towards it? First thing is I need to figure out the values with regard to this formula. Okay, this formula I need to find out. So what is going to happen? It is nothing but 1 minus, same thing, I'm putting the values here, okay, nothing new I'm doing. 1 minus summation of up one first value to last value. Okay, first value to last value we need to figure out. Okay, in this, there's only one bad. What about good? Good is 0. But both the things I need to figure out. Okay, good and bad, both the things I need to figure out. So 2 is bad, other one is good. You know, good is 0 only. Okay, because that's not at all there. So I can write like this. What is the value we have? 2. So this is 1 minus, I'll write it in brackets, 0 good out of 2. What is that 2? This one. Plus, be careful, this is plus. Entropy, it was minus. Here it is plus. Why? Because inside you see this. This minus you leave. Okay, this minus is this minus. I'm talking about this side, inside this. Okay, 0 out of 2. Plus, what's the next thing? Next thing is, you can see very clearly, I need to write this one. Okay, I need to write this one. So what needs to be done here? Very simple. Okay, see, good is written. Now I need to write for bad. 2 out of 2, which is bad. But this needs to be in whole squares. So I'm going to write it in whole square. 2 out of 2, the whole square. Okay, what is the value that you're supposed to get? Very simple. You can calculate here itself. 1 minus 0 by 2 whole square, it's not infinity, 0. Okay, plus 2 by 2, 2 by 2 matlab 2 by 2, 1 square. 1 minus 1, 0. This is equal to 0. Okay, the information gain with regard to this, you're getting it as 0. What? For the left hand side branch. Now, if I figure out the values with regard to this one, using the same old formula. Okay, what's the value you get? 1 minus, what is the first thing? First thing is with regard to 2 good. Okay, 2 goods you have, total amount is 3. That you should not forget. Total you get is 3. Okay, so 2 out of 3, which is with regard to good. Here also first I figure out for good only. Good should always come first, then the bad. Okay, or else if you are a bad person, do it for bad person, bad values. Okay, now you see 2 out of 2 by 3, the whole square. Plus, next thing is with regard to bad, 1 out of 3, the whole square. Okay, what is the value you get for this? Let me, you know, sort of, one second, I'll move the screen. Yeah. 1 minus, what is the value you get for this? 4 by 9 plus 1 by 9. Why I'm writing? Because the square part. Okay, this will happen because to what? 1 minus 5 by 9. Okay. 4 plus 1, 5 by, because the denominator is same. Okay, what is the value you get? 4 by 9. Or what is the other way of saying it? 4 by 9 means you can use it using your calculator, 4 by 9. What's the value you get? 0.3 something. Okay, let me check the exact values of it. 4 divided by 9. Not 3, 0.444. Okay, so 0.44. Here, information gain was equal to 0. Here the information gain was equal to 0.44. But what is the meaning of this? Okay, what do you decide? How do you think the decided would be done? Okay, the decision will be done. That's very important, right? This is with regard to information gain. There is one more term. Okay, what is that one more term that you're supposed to get? That is, once again, I'll move the screen. Okay, please zoom in if you can't see. Okay, use your fingers to zoom in. I need to figure out the next thing called weighted. Okay, weighted gain. What is weighted gain? You are going to figure out the what is known as the probabilities and with information gain. How it is all done? Very simple. Okay, you are going to figure out the good values of it. Okay, what's a good value? You're going to take the good values and multiply with this, bad values and multiply with this, like that you're supposed to. Okay, that is with regard to known as weighted gain. How do you do it? 2/5 into the values with regard to this one, which is 0, plus 3/5 bad ones into the ones which you got here, okay, which is 4/9 or 0.44, whatever you got. That you get it as weighted gain. This weighted gain is not needed for you in data mining, but it's very important if you're figuring out the program for figuring out or to find out your entropy, information gain, weighted gain. When you're writing a program there, now this will become very important. The values of this, once you get to know this, you will be able to get to value, know these values also. Okay, all these things you are going to put in form of a formula in a program there. Okay, for us only up to here is important. Okay, with regard to information gain. So based on this, how do you figure out? Okay, so based on this information gain, you can say, what is my best root node? Okay, what is my best root node? Two things you can use. Either you can use entropy or you can use what is known as information gain. Now using information gain, okay, how do you think the decision tree can be done? Information gain will be telling you what is known as which is the best root node. So you are going to do it using comparing the entropy of data set before and after the transmission of it. That is all two complex topics. Okay, but you got to know two things here. One is how entropy will be changing it. Okay, and how information gain is changing it. So minimum gain index or minimum information gain, if you have it, okay, or what is the other way of talking about it? If your information gain, okay, one second, if your information gain, I'm talking about the best case, if your information gain is anywhere equal to 0, then you can say that is the best place for you to split your decision tree, or for that to be your root node in your decision tree. And what is the worst case? The worst case will be coming through like this. If it is equal to 1, because you know it is anywhere between 0 and 1 only. You saw here it was coming up to 0. Here it is coming up to 0.44. Okay, so here you say up to 1 means this is the worst case scenario. You should not be able to choose this. Even if you choose this, it will not be a very good decision tree. See, at the end of the day, it's all coming up to the point called decision tree. Why you need this decision tree? To figure out what is my best solution or which is my best optimum way to go in terms of, you know, if you're choosing a path or not. Okay, so this is how you're going to figure out. And here in terms of it, we are talking decision tree, root node, anything that is having a information gain close to 0. Generally, very, very rare cases that you get 0 like this. I've taken that example to show you that, you know, the values will be between your 0 and 1. Okay, in real, you know, data set example, it will be anywhere between your 0 to 1 only. Okay, people will always try to figure out an information gain which is almost closer to 0 as much as possible to say that this is the best decision tree that can have. Okay, now why do you think this became a best decision tree? Because of a very simple thing. Why? There was only one thing that you had here. Okay, there was only one thing that you have here. Two bad examples, two bad loan status there, 0 good loan status. Here you had a mix up of data. See, two good, one bad. Okay, take your own class for example. If everyone is good. Okay, if everyone is good, I don't have to worry. If there is a mix up of things, what is your class time? 53, 30, 23. Okay, if there is a mix like this, then we need to, you know, sort of take care. Okay, we need to sort of take care because two things are also coming through them. Okay, so this is with regard to, you know, very, very important topics, especially those people who are going to work in, it comes to projects in your machine learning, you know, data science and all, you have to know these sort of things. Okay, in detail, you're going to learn in next semester, but from data point of view, What is the things to be known? What is the definition? Do you know the definition of entropy information gain? Yes. Do you know the formula of it? Yes. That's the end of it. You're not going to go much deeper into it. All these sort of things is not known, you know, it's not needed for you, but it's good that you know it. Okay. Very important program. ID3 also it will be you are going to learn. Okay. It's not there in data mining syllabus, but if time permits, if you are, you know, if you are able to complete all this syllabus, you know, earlier, then we'll be, you know, I'll be able to talk, you know, teach you that ID3 things also. Okay. At the end of the day, why did we come across here? We came across because of this. Okay. Decision tree induction. If you are able to split, see this example. Okay. One second. Let it become a, yeah, now it's able to visible, I guess. Now you see, why did we come across? We came across this because of this point. Instead of defining a speech purity, the impurity of the child is, you know, by use. So for figuring out this, we have number of various measurements, starting from entropy, Gini index, classification error. Classification error is nothing but, you know, where do you think the values will be coming through? Anyway, I'm going to show that in our next thing. That's a very theoretical part. These two are very, very important. Okay. So in the next class, what is going to happen? We are going to look into this, our theory part of it. Okay. And then what is the next part? Next part is we are going to look into the classifications, or not classification, the characteristics of your decision tree. And then the entire part of your decision tree will be done. Then the next part is rule-based classifiers. We are moving into the next three parts of it. Rule-based classifiers, Bayesian classifiers and all. Okay, that will be easily taking up to at least 6-7 sessions. Okay, minimum 6-7 sessions it will take. Then only we'll be able to complete our fourth module. Then again, the fifth module is remaining. So still at least, I don't know, maybe 2-3 weeks of data is remaining. We'll try to figure out, okay, if there is anything in between coming through, okay, we'll figure out the classes. Okay, so see, I think you must be knowing it's a open choice question paper for you people. Yesterday, ma'am would have put the circular and all. So what is the meaning of that? It means that you can write any 5 questions. Okay, any 5 questions means you can go with like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So any person who read 2.5 modules also can be able to do it. But my suggestion is please read all the modules and then figure out your best 2.5 modules. First read all the 5 modules. Otherwise it doesn't do any justice to the subject. Okay, passing the subject is of no use. You have to go there and figure out what is the things that is there, because it will be, this will become very important here next up.